this it's a young, dynamic, versatile surgeon practicing in Chaliisgaon, Maharashtra, with many firsts to his name in his zone. As far as premium cataract surgery is concerned, I'm introducing to you all Dr. Amit Kumar Mahajan, and he is going to show us an easy way to deal with a particular moment. On to you, Dr. Amit.
Good evening, everyone. At the outset, I would like to thank All India Society and Chitra ma'am for giving me this opportunity. As we all know that so
can you
many
share
things
your
have...
No, we can't
see. Yes.
Yeah, we did.
Is it visible?
No.
Mr. Dr. Arun Sethi, can you share his video?
As we all know that so many things...
Okay.
Is it started? I think Dr.
Mahajan started. Yes, go ahead.
Started. Have been said and done about the management of posterior polar cataract, but still the mystery continues. So in this video, I will be sharing a new technique of nucleus debulking in slightly harder grade of posterior polar cataract. The first and the most crucial step is properly size rhexis. It should be at least 5.5 mm, as a smaller rhexis may invite many surgical difficulties. 2.2 main wound is done. Now small aliquots of fluid injected in multiple quadrants, taking care that fluid wave should not cross the center. Now a small central deep trench is made as usual, and then without rotating the nucleus, using torsional Ozil power, horizontal trench is made exactly perpendicular to the original vertical trench, so as to make a plus sign. But here we don't have to rotate the nucleus. We are using the torsional power to make this horizontal trench. Now, without rotation, nucleus is cracked in all the four quadrants from periphery to center without disturbing the central plaque. Here, the separation should be proper, gradual and sharp in all the four quadrants. You can take a multiple attempts, but separation should be proper from periphery towards the center and keep the central plaque attached as it is, so that now you have got four separate pieces attached centrally like a flower petals. Now you can easily hold the apex of the piece with the Phaco Pro and disengage with the chopper from the periphery easily and emulsify at the pupillary plane with very low parameters, like water light should be 50 to 60 millimeter, flow rate should be around 25 to 30, and a vacuum up about 250 or 300 is more than sufficient. That is what you require to emulsify these separated pieces in the center. Now, after easily emulsifying these four pieces, you are left with a thick epinuclear sheet with cortex. So here I always prefer bimanual than the coaxial because it helps me in 360 degree removal. Here tip is to position your aspiration cannula exactly below the anterior capsule rim. Hold and occlude the cortical sheet, not the epinuclear plate. Swap it horizontally to loosen the adhesions, and then finally pull it in a posterior direction towards the central plaque, up to the plaque. Repeat the same thing in all the 360 direction so that the cortex is loosened from the periphery, but keep it attached centrally. And in the last, finally, you can remove the central plaque very easily like a flower petal direction, so that first lose all the cortex from the periphery. Now always keep in mind to do the viscofluid exchange. Before removing irrigation cannula, always fill the chamber with the visco to avoid unnecessary shallowing of the chamber. So to conclude, you must have at least 5.5 mm oval shape rhexis, no fluid wave crossing the center, very low parameter central trenching in both the direction, separation of all the quadrants from periphery but keep it attached centrally, viscofluid exchange, and bimanual IA in a flower petal type of fashion. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Amit. And really wonderful the way you showed how you have to get the cortex cleared all 360 degrees before you remove it, and a very safe method. Would you use the same technique for all grades of cataract or only for this moderate cataract?
No, this is a slightly harder type of cataract, like NS3 or 4. Otherwise, soft cataract, we can get a smooth wave of hydrodelination and we can easily manage the nucleus. But in this harder type of grades, though they are rare in posterior polar cataract, but it is very difficult to get a hydrodelination wave in this harder type of cataract. So I reserve this technique only for like NS3 or harder type of posterior polar cataracts.
In soft cataract, sometimes it is not possible to control your wave.
Yes.
It just stop short there. But in this case that you classically shown, I think it was very nicely shown that it, you know, just stop short there.
Before we go on to our next speaker, just one question which maybe Namrata would be better able to answer. We'll compare the role of AS OCT with intra-op OCT in posterior polar cataract. Like AS OCT, we do have high false negative. But how do you feel intra-op OCT, like how would you rate it? For polar cataract,
no, I think you are very right. In AS OCT, there is that chance which is there, but at intra-op OCT, it does not happen because it's not one static picture, so it keeps changing. And you can also change your focus, you know, on your right, on your left. You can scan the entire thing from one end to the other. So that sort of a chance is, you know, much less with the intra-op OCT microscope because it will give you live, dynamic views. And the scans at which, you know, they are taken, you keep changing. So you can construct that whole thing, you know, in your mind and then can avoid that false negative.
Thank you very much, Amit.
Yeah, Dr. Chitra, I'd like to congratulate Dr.
Yes.
Amit for this very,
yes,
very,
very
nice looking technique.
Yeah.
Very
nice.
Nicely. Only tip to suggestion to you is try to contact somebody who makes these tips and try to change the orientation or the direction of bend a little more so that you can create a better sideways movement. And also splitting it like this, you actually can hold the piece and cross split so that you can hold it more controlled,
yes,
rather than using it like a split divide and conquer kind of split.
Dr. Mino,
and towards the end, towards the end, we will all become very happy with this posterior polars and hydrate off the sides and the edges, and then you'll inflate the back so much. I have had two cases of PC ripping just by hydrating and getting more fluid into the anterior chamber. So hydrating also has to be done gently and let fluid out a little bit when you are hydrating. But
very
again,
good.
Congrats for the great idea.
Chitra,
yes.
Just
yes.
A word, Chitra.
Yes, come on.
I think Dr. Amit did a beautiful surgery. We described this in 2005, the whole procedure of centripetal non-rotating movement. It was in JCRS. And the only thing, I agree with Dr. Mino, the only thing good modification is done is four quadrant, but it's a very good idea. You just split it and hold one edge and just pull the D. So I call this the new D technique. We're also publishing that. It's called the D technique. You don't need to split it. Just hold one edge of the D, pull it out of the oval capsular axis, hold the other edge of the split D. You don't need to divide or crack. And centripetal IA, it just is over in minutes. 2 minutes, 3 minutes, polar cataract over.
Yes.
Yeah. Over, provided there's no rupture at the back. Otherwise, it's not over until it is over.
Even if there is a rupture, Namrata, even if there is a rupture, I have yet to ever get vitreous in the AC, and I can vouch for it. I have probably done more than 700 polar cataracts in the last 600 years. All my centers, they send all their polar cataracts to me. So I get a lot of polar cataracts from even just my centers alone. You, even if you have a PC opening, my YouTube channel is full of that. Even if you have a PC opening, since you've not disturbed the anterior vitreous face, you are easily able to put the IOL in.